good.
Sure.
My hands just get too shaky.
The back row one, so you go.
Ooh, this is fun. Fun view. Thank you. Come on.
Set the flaps to 5, Charlie. Flaps are there.
Yeah, it's fine.
Hold up. They're not gonna run you. They're on the engine running. That's usually like taxiing away from the gate.
Oh, all right. Okay. I usually do it there just so I don't forget.
Well, we don't have anything running yet.
Okay.
Okay. As far as hydraulic stuff.
Altimeter. Oh, we need.
It's okay.
All
right. We need that CG. If you just bring that CG, just hit CG there. That on the left side CG. Just hit it again and bring it back up.
So our rotate speed is going to be 145. Hold on, I'm going to look at the METAR and
somehow get it.
Turn that to 3004. Are we real world weather?
can set up something else if you like to. You want to go work? I mean, the other day I had this thing quit. So many things on. It's just a thought. And I can put in, like, if I can bring the weather down.
I mean, I prefer real world weather.
Okay.
Okay.
Go outside and do that. I can give that a shot.
So the altitude measurement is by air pressure. So we have to set based on the actual current air pressure. So I just looked up what it is in Denver.
Currently?
Yeah.
Okay.
3004. So
okay.
That's why we set that up.
That's
there.
Fine.
Now,
that's
when
fine.
We get up to 18,000 feet, we'll push that button for standard because it goes with standard barometric pressure. When we get to 18,000 feet, it goes to standard.
There you go. Yep.
All right. So APU bleed should be off. That's up here. That's APU bleed. It is off. Left aft fuel pump. That's me.
Yep.
Here. On. APU hold for 3 seconds. One. Three. Now that dial should start coming up. So there's a little extra engine to help start the main engine. That's called APU. So now this should, there it goes. So the APU started.
Exactly.
When the APU generator's available, that light comes out on alternating.
Show you something else while you wait.
Uh-huh.
Quick.
Yeah.
Light test when you get in a cold, dark airplane.
Uh-huh.
That light test light right there.
Uh-huh.
Put that in test, please. And you get all the lights. Uh-huh. And you kind of, when you first get in the airplane, when it's cold and dark, then you look on the overhead here and look around and just see if there's any lights that are not operational. That'd be something you would typically do.
Yeah.
Including your fire lights and all this stuff down in here. Just showing you that.
Yeah.
Okay.
My list doesn't have any of the
test
stuff.
Like that.
Yeah, it doesn't have test
stuff. Like
this
that.
Is like the concise get you off the ground.
Okay. All
right. So that's available. So we will turn on the APU generator.
I'll try that. Try that switch over there. Get those lights.
This
see
one.
That? Yeah. See that? I don't know why that's not
connected. It feels like it's not connected. Oh.
I don't know why that's.
Ah, like, there we go.
Very good, Brad. Hey,
oh.
Look those up.
Look at it, please.
There okay.
Go.
There you go.
Okay.
Thank you. Thanks. I feel better now.
APU bleed, that's it. APU bleed on. That one. Just pull it out down. Okay. So we're on APU bleed there. Okay. Now, ACDC voltmeter back / APU gen. Flight director's on. Okay. So you see this little thing there? Flight director? Right here. Turn that on. Actually, we don't need to do the autopilot.
That's
off. Well, all right, so set this to V2 plus 15. So 152 plus 15 would be 170.
Want me to set this to 22,000?
Sure. We'll go through all that in a little bit.
Electric hydraulic pump.
That one.
On.
On.
He's called the other there.
Oh.
Yep.
Do I have to do something? then? Oh, I got a release of parking brake.
This really technically, I don't know how your checklist reads, but that would be off.
It says on.
Yeah, really?
Yeah,
the two A's would be off, A's off, B's on. Because that's on the nose wheel steering, so you don't want that to mess up with
you. Yeah, it says both engine hydraulic.
Okay.
Whatever.
Okay, what do we want to do?
Where are we going? We're pushing back from the gate. Oh, we were at a weird meet gate. Well, that's why it looks weird. Because there's no, there's no jetway. We were at one of the little, anyway, okay. Anti-collision light, that's you. Anti-collision light on.
Where is it? Anti-collision light on.
Oh, jeez. That one doesn't pull out. The small ones don't pull out. Okay. We're not going to do them all over. Okay, left and right packs, that's you. Left and right packs on.
Set parking brake, he's saying.
Left and right packs. Yep. So left and right on.
Auto or on?
Oh, I'm sorry. Left and right packs. Well, off. I'm sorry. Off. Off.
Off.
That's my bad.
Be off until you start the engine.
They're on.
Okay, ignition should be right. That's fine. Engine 2 start switch.
Stop you a second.
Yeah.
I can show you something.
Yeah.
I turn all the fuel pumps on now. All the pumps have been on. Just start.
That's after I get them on.
You got them on. I want to have them all on. All
right.
Pretty sure they'd be all on. Even the center ones.
Okay.
What I would say.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So engine 2 start. So push this in and turn it to GRD.
This is G.
G. Watch down here when this gets to 25.
You're doing good, man. You're doing good.
This is 25. Wow.
Not his
25.
First rodeo.
Pull it up. Yeah, when he gets to 25, then you'll pull it up and you pull it. You put all the way on. Pull it up to 20. Oh.
That's all right.
Yeah, it's hard to see my thing. Okay. All the way up. Okay, good.
Can you see?
Okay. Better with the light. Huh?
Okay, and I'll show you something else.
Yeah.
Is that it?
The other one.
There's,
yeah.
I'll show you something else. There's a
flashlight.
Yes. There's a map light there.
Oh, yeah.
It comes over your shoulder right over here on your left.
Okay.
Up here.
Okay,
right
that's
there.
Good. Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
All right.
Turn that back.
All right, you can turn this. You can turn that off if you want.
That's what I would typically use. Typically.
Okay. we did that. Engine 1 start. That's me. GRD. And when that comes up to 25, I'll do the same on my side. See where we are?
Yeah, that's right here.
Okay. So we're on engine 1 start level idle at 25.
Yeah.
Okay.
Excellent.
Okay.
Excellent.
Now, system 1 and 2 gens, or engine 1 and 2 gens on. Auto brake is right there. there, RTO.
Got it.
Okay. Strobe, so the position lights should be to strobe and standby. Stop.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I forgot that again. It's not cool.
It's just landing lights. Oh, I did that.
And extended.
Okay. Oh, set our,
come on around here, dude.
It feels good. The video on the auto is very good.
Well, it was like when I was focusing on the paper and the city.
Yeah. I know what you mean exactly. Exactly.
What am I doing? You want to control the throttle? I'm going to push it forward right now. Just a little bit.
Just with the taxi wise, you kind of come forward, give it a little thrust, then kind of back, then bring it all the way back. Bring it all the way back. Then you kind of get you. It's kind of like pushing it a little bit, you know, and let off of it, and let it glide.
Oh wait, there's a sign. Hold up the sign. Let's see what it says.
You can see your ground speed.
That's
right there.
L.
Right there. See that GS?
Oh,
doing
okay.
20.
Okay.
You're doing 20.
So we want to go to Mike. Here's Mike. We want to go to Mike 10.
We're going
to
need to slow down and make the turn.
Which I think I want to go here. I'll call Mike.
Touch your brakes and just touch your left brakes a little bit. Slow down. There you go. There's 4. There's 10, 9. That's
so
better.
We're going to go to Mike 10, which I think will be this one over here.
Yeah, you go left, then go right to be at Mike 10. Exactly. And that'll take you to the end of the runway of 17th, right? Wow. Oh, see, I can watch it here on the sea, imagine moving here.
Oh,
the
nice.
Airport area.
Right.
What's the permit? Forget the checklist. We're done with the checklist.
Forget the checklist.
Oh. Okay, so here's runway 17, right? This is, actually, I think this is the one. I think this is the runway we took. No, we took off from runway 8.
You wanna.
Turn onto the runway. Make sure the throttles are all the way back.
Are you going to use the auto throttle?
Later.
Okay. How are you like doing it?
It's funny because the biz jets of the flight don't have auto throttle.
I can.
So I'm actually not used to it.
Okay.
Oh.
Hey.
All right. Are you going to take off? Yeah, do you want to fly and take off?
No, you should do it. Just do it.
You can do it. It's easy.
All right.
So
I use my feet.
Don't touch the
brakes.
The
brakes.
Right.
Okay. Stay off the brakes. It's probably
so
better.
You steer with your right, with your feet.
Yeah.
And when you take off, when we get to rotate, I'll tell you when. You're
if,
gonna,
if I push left, does it turn left?
Yes.
Right?
When
you push
right, it turns right.
It takes
left, it turns left.
It takes very little of any rudder to keep it down the road center.
Yep.
It's really sensitive.
When we get to the takeoff speed, which is about 140, 150.
Somewhere in that range.
All right.
Yeah,
I'll say rotate, and then you'll pull back, and this is the tilt. All right, you ready?
You'll call V.
How much should I push it?
So you want to get it to the little green thing?
Yes.
You want to get the, there'll be a little thing, and you just want to get it right in that little green area.
Oh boy.
Brakes. Hang on.
I'll pump the throttle all the way up. All right, there you go. Just steer a little bit. Keep us right in the center.
Doesn't take much. You just think about it almost.
I didn't engage there for some reason or why.
gosh.
They're just flying the whole thing. So keep it right about there. You see where the horizon is? So you want to keep the dot above the horizon. Keep this climbing. Keep turning to the right.
Take it.
Okay, so how far are we? Let's see.
Thanks.
I think it's 111. 1.5 on both sides at the top. There you go. And of course, inbound, you're doing that one. Which course? I guess the course that is 151.
One? Yeah.
You put it in there, but you also put in that little box down there, too.
Oh, I see that. Maybe 13.3 it shows, yeah. Okay. Now you're an Aspen. You're coming on the map. You're on my map now. You're an Aspen for sure.
Alright, it's gonna be just over this ridge and then the left turn. It's gonna be.
We're gonna make a left 90 degree turn here, so to speak. Non-precision approach, huh?
Yeah, there's no altitude.
No glide slope.
Nope.
Okay.
And it's a steep descent. It's like a 60-degree descent.
We're probably going to need, if we can't get those flaps anymore, we're probably going to need to go to maximum brakes there. My guesstimation. Yeah, I don't need the flaps to work. The approach speed's going to be pretty fast.
I think the flaps are working.
Yeah, I couldn't get them to move. I don't know why. Unless I can reset the computer. They went to 5. They've been at 5 the whole time. For some reason, I don't know why.
What?
Yeah, you do better.
Alright, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Almost time for chaos.
You guys want to do
it? Here we go.
Wow, that one should be able to see the runway.
Wait. Dad, turn and say cheese. There we go. New profile picture.
You can see them on this map right here. So we'll come right here. Red triangle there.
Okay.
And then come around and go that way.
Okay.
That's the approach plate there. There they are on the map right there. Right
here. See all right.
That's a shoot there.
Yes. All of our dad. Yeah.
Okay.
We're all siblings.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Okay, great.
I see it. There's the cloud that's kind of
the runway right there.
Yeah,
we're too high. All those white lights mean we're
Your approach speed's going to be correct, okay?
Another notch of flaps, please.
Three, 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 three,
coming in hot because we're descending six laps.
Hey, you got speed brakes, okay, got
you. Woo! Here we are.
Hey, you're looking at it right there. Doing good, man. I'm impressed.
The landing's probably gonna be rough.
All right, fine. Can't wait for it.
I'm trying to slow down.
Don't crash.
We're going too fast.
Should I put down the?
Oh, we just turned to red. We're too low.
Uh-oh.
Whoa. Just leave it like that.
You got flaps 30. You can already go 42.
40.
So 40, they go. Right. Flaps are down. I see you.
Nice. We were really fun.
Whoa, there, buddy.
Disengage.
Come on.
All right.
Whoa. Oxygen masks.
It's going to be real bumpy. Can't wait.
I'm going to turn off the elevator.
Keep her coming down.
Yeah, you're looking good.
Since I got the oxygen masks.
Oh, boy.
Really
here we go.
This is really heavy. Oh, my gosh. This plane feels really heavy.
Don't crash us. I thought it turned my chair around and it just said
I don't remember.
Oh, you could grab that another chair. There's one there.
That's what I'm saying.
I might just stand, honestly.
Okay, so for this one, we're going to go JNC.
See that? And you can put those brakes, the next switch to the left of the flaps, the brakes, put them on RTO there. That little knob, just turn it all the way around, RTO. Take off. There you go. Cool. I'm just glad to
flaps started working. I thought it got to start.
Can you want
to
take off?
Sure.
Take off.
All right. Except the landing will be better. I just
yeah, it will.
And the takeoff will be better.
Well, takeoff was pretty good.
Yeah,
really.
It was pretty good.
Really.
Yeah. Yeah, over everything.
We are taxiing down the taxiway. It's going to be down our takeoff on the runway 33 going northwest here. That's us taxiing right there.
We'll go down and turn around.
Turn around and come back.
What is this trigger?
Oh, I see. So we'll go down this
way.
Let's
go back up. Probably for the radio.
It's kind of foggy.
It's pretty crazy.
Look, there's some floating houses right there.
Kind of got fog down here in the valley or something.
Oh, look at that.
Well, there's the wind socks, you know, just a little floating. Actually, that's not really showing much of it.
Oh, floating houses. Good. All right.
Crazy.
Oh boy. Can't see anything. So foggy.
So how realistic is this actually piloting?
Well, it's pretty good. That's pretty real. Like I said, this is the real thing. We had used United for 10 days. We were transitioning. Like called out captain. And then it's another 10 days in a full motion set. Just tell us this. We're on top of big stilts and roofs. It's costing about 20, 30 million each.
We have 40 of them.
We use the rudders.
So use the rudders to steer. Each. And then when I say rotate, you're going to pull back.
It's a real airplane, but that's for
you take off.
Sure,
and then you just let the rudders go after you take
feel it.
Yeah.
And you're going to follow.
I was out there about a few weeks ago. I saw the transition again.
Yeah, can you even imagine if we were in that for Aspen landing? Oh my
goodness. So my son spent 30 days in the training center. He goes out and flies for a couple of weeks in a real airplane.
So it's
with
another instructor.
Are you ready?
Another captain is playing co-pilot.
You want me to hear? I'll throw you out. All right, are you ready?
Yeah, he kind of signs you off.
Parking brake is off.
He's on his own.
Awesome.
He gets the airplane and gets random co-pilots. He's a captain now for about 2 or 3 weeks.
Here we go.
Ready? Oh boy, okay.
He's with United also.
My mother's son's a captain with Southwest. My brother's a captain with United, and his son's a co-pilot. There's 5 of us. There's 5 of us total.
Okay. That's good.
Line over there?
Okay, no, but on the right side, you see the line at 3900?
make that more like 2,000 or 2,500, okay? You're too, a little too high. Okay, left turn to Lindsay. See Lindsay there?
I see.
Whoa!
I hate that when that happens.
Okay. So that's one says depth R, departure arrival. Press that. Then KTEX ARR for arrival. Now we're going to do the localizer 09 approach. Transition ETL. Press that one. And then execute. Okay, now go back to legs. There's a discontinuity. So you see how you got the same thing there?
Yeah.
So press the button next to the bottom, the ETL there. And then press the one at the top to move it up there. And now press execute. Okay, so now we're all set. So now if you look at the map, you can see MTJ is Montrose. So we're going to go Montrose, and then Coons, and then we come around the mountains, and then Telluride's kind of in a little valley there.
Okay. So we are at cruising, so I'm going to take us up to like 320. It's a little faster.
Right.
CJ, what's that next one? Where the top of your sensor?
220.
220? Yeah, so put, make that big. Put 220 there again. 220, like 22,000. Try that. Plug it in right there. There you go. Now hit you. Now execute that. Now hit your VDAP. I think it'll come on. There you go.
Oh.
See what I mean?
No, it didn't. It didn't?
It didn't? Okay, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
Okay. I thought that was, I thought it came on for a second. So much. Oops.
Okay. So we are 17 nautical miles from top of descent. 47, 3 minutes is when we're going to start descending.
Thank you.
at that at like 2. It's good. Flight 2 good. Then, so after we make the turn, we're going to go to like flaps 5, and then we're going to start stepping it down.
Just a hair.
So we should be at 11,500. good. Turn on our landing lights. Do some more flaps.
Oops. Can't go any more flaps.
What?
Can't go any more until you put the gear down.
Oh, all right. I'll go ahead and put the gear down. Gear down.
15's max without the gear.
Put some flaps down.
Good job, good job.
Thanks, Charlie.
All right, I'm
going to
turn
the seat belts off. Seatbelts off.
My plane. It's not like Star Trek 25.
Better this time, right?
Yep, it looks like.
It already seems better.
They're all better. Oh, wow.
It's not all like.
Look at that. Cool. Taxiing in like this, you want to do this, a good coat box, you bring the flaps and come up, all the way up.
We'll pull up against the orifice.
There you go. keep coming all the way up. All this is your
bring it out. There you go. Let's fuel up. Send the brake.
And then you need to start the APU again if you want to. Crank that up so it doesn't go on the battery when you shut down the engines. Turn off your lights. Cool. As soon as that APU's up, we'll put it on the buses. So we're starting that little engine, that jet engine back there to get electrical power, so when we shut down the engines, we got power instead of just going on the battery.
as soon as this light comes back up, wherever that, up here, where's it in?
That's right there.
That one, yeah, electrical panel.
Good job, man.
Wow.